And welcome. Today is February 22nd, 2014. And we're here at the Northford Ice Pavilion for the big matchup between the Mark T. Sheehan High School Titans and the Lyman Hall HK Trojan co-op team. I'm here with Bree Petroselli. How are you doing today, Bree?
Not bad. How are you this lovely evening?
I am excited. This game is a little bit delayed. We had some lateness beforehand in the Brantford game against Foran. Brantford won very handily. And so we're happy to be here, and the Zamboni has come through, and we've got a great service for these guys to play on today.
Well, we are very excited, as you can tell. The boys are just getting ready, like stick checks and helmets over there.
Now, Brian, tonight's game, what kind of expectations do we have? I know that we had a game last time that Sheehan did very well. What do you think is going to be your prediction for this evening?
Well, I believe that after last time winning 8-2, which is a stellar lead, Titans took over heavily in the second period. I think that the Titans will have a strong lead coming out based on their previous wins. They've had a great season. But, I mean, you never know what the Trojans are going to be ready to bring and counter back to us.
Now, size-wise, I mean, just looking at them from a distance, it looks like Sheehan does have a significant advantage in size.
Yes, there are many more players on our side than the Lyman Hall side. We do have a lot of new freshmen and underclassmen, sophomores. The Gazzo brothers were a huge addition this year.
Now, it comes to style and tactics. What kind of tactics does Sheehan favor? What's their kind of play? Are they a rough play, finesse? What kind of team is the Sheehan hockey team, as someone who's watched them all season long?
Well, it's very interesting, actually. I feel like their opponent depends on how they play. They know when to stay on defense and how to manage it, but they also know when to step it up and to be ready, and they know how to definitely match up their opponents. That's to say one thing.
Now, let's take a look. I know Sheehan's got a very special goal. You got Carly Femniak in goal, doing a fantastic job in goal. She played goalie for the field hockey team, made All-State honors. Now she's here in the ice hockey doing some great work for the Sheehan. What can you say about Carly?
Carly deserves an enormous amount of props for the work that she puts on. I mean, you look at some of these kids, 18, 19-year-old boys, putting a stick in their hand and slamming a puck at her. I mean, not to say that girls are not strong, but in this game particularly, for her to be able to portray what she has done all season and to have the courage to come out here and to face these boys who are quite frankly amazing. I mean, look at the teams that they've played and how well they've handled it. I mean, the 8-2 says it all.
And Carly's not the only female out there for Sheehan today, huh?
No, Maddie McNamee, number 4, is a sophomore. She is the sister of Jimmy McNamee, number 17, who is a senior. And she's been working real hard.
And now we're going to take a pause, and we're going to listen to our national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for a moment of silence. Last night, the Lyman Hall community lost one of its very own. Caitlin Carty, in the class of 2013, passed away unexpectedly in a car accident. She was captain of the cheerleading squad last year. Can we all bow our heads, please, for a moment of silence for Caitlin? Thank you. Please remain standing for the playing of our national anthem. Thank you.
All right, now, that was a nice tribute that was said for that young lady who passed on, and we
yes.
are, our condolences go out to Lyman Hall and all their friends and family.
And especially the Carney family, of which Caitlin Carney unexpectedly passed away before yesterday. It's said to be in a car accident. So thoughts and prayers for them and during this tough time.
How does that affect the mindset of the Lyman Hall team? Does that inspire them a little bit?
You know, that's actually a really good thought, because I was thinking about that on the way here, actually, and you wonder, it could either have one or two effects. I mean, more of a positive one to play, or, I mean, obviously there's upperclassmen and senior boys. She was a beautiful girl who obviously was very popular, and she, as they said, cheerleading captain and stuff. She obviously had a good impact. People were tweeting about it all over social media today, saying her lovely smile and her beautiful personality are going to be truly missed. So with that being said, I feel like it's going to be a good impact for these boys. But also the Wallingford boys on Sheehan's side took a stance saying that everyone now has someone to play for to unite the community.
That's right. Well, this is one community, one town, and even though it's two sides of the track, it definitely everyone comes together and something big happens like that. So, but back to the game, we see our team getting started up here. And can you talk a little bit about the captains?
The captains are number 8, Christian Jackandino, who is one of their top scorers with 11 goals this season. And his co-captain is Michael Capozzi, who's also starting tonight, number 24, who has also had 10 goals, being a top scorer in the top 4 and 5 this season. And then they're assisted by number 17, Jimmy McNamee, as an assistant captain. All three key players who are they're going to be missing next year, to say the least.
And Sheehan wins. That's Mike Cerati with the faceoff.
And a slam into the boards.
It looks like Sheehan has come ready to play. There is a whistle.
They're definitely fueled up from yesterday. They had a nice pasta party over at the Bodwin's house, so they're definitely not lacking any energy, that's for sure.
Shot on goal by number 6, Shane Duhamel. Stopped by Carly Femniak.
The Sheehan offense has just stopped. And a line change. 2 minutes in.
Very electric music in this place tonight, huh?
Electric music, electric fans, electric game, I guess you could say.
Sounds like Mr. Cerullo's DJing up there. That's great.
A shot on goal.
And you know, that goalie kept
blocked.
The stick down. If he had caught that a little bit harder. Oh, they got to clear the zone.
Paul Gazzo bringing it around.
And Mike Capozzi is right in the mix there. He's not ashamed to get right into the mix.
Oh, no.
Oh, and there is
he's
a penalty.
He's not shy, to say the least.
The penalty's apparently on Sheehan.
And the goalie for Lyman Hall has been taken out.
And the penalty is on number 15, Sal Gazzo.
A 2 minute early on here with 13:59 left on the clock of the first period.
Yeah, this is not something Sheehan wanted to do very early, to have a power play opportunity for Lyman Hall with 1 minute in the game.
Defense and aggressiveness are here on the ice tonight.
Well, the key is that let's see how the Sheehan penalty kill, if they can clear the zone a few times and get this penalty killed. And they clear the zone, and that's going to kill some time. Give it a little chance to reset. Lyman Hall, 1 minute 30 on the power play remaining.
Nick Baracco from Lyman Hall taking it up the ice, stopped by 17 Jimmy McNamee.
I tell you, Jimmy took a big hit there, but he's still right in there. He's still
right
protecting
that
puck. Two Lyman Hall players couldn't get away from it. It took them a while.
Shot on goal. Ooh, deflected by number 3.
And they cleared the zone again.
A forward pass looked like it was intended for Colin Bodwin.
She didn't get some fresh legs on the ice. Mike Cerati's back in, playing a little defense. They dump it into the zone deep. A bit of a scrum down in that corner. Sheehan's doing a good job trying to control the puck in their own side, even though they're outnumbered.
Another slam into the boards. Colin Bodwin on defense.
And they clear the zone once again. 22
eight.
Seconds left, in the, but they're surging ahead. Look at this. Number
Dylan
18.
Bodwin.
Dylan is not backing off. And he's hitting as well.
Jimmy McAmey with a slap
8 seconds in the power play remaining.
Deep on the ice.
And Sheehan has effectively killed that power play. Nice job, Sheehan. Well done.
Great defense by Michael Capozzi.
I think Mike Cerati has been in every play here in these last few seconds. Wherever the puck is, he just gravitates to it.
That is to say, in the least, he's involved mostly with every single play. He was a transfer from Xavier Ice Hockey.
And he almost put that puck right in the goal. Just missed.
Posey recovering after the hit from number six.
And it bounces
Shane
right off the
Duhamel.
Goalie's foot. He's kicked out. Jimmy McAmey giving the Sheehan players a chance to reset. Dumps it into the zone.
It almost looked as though that pass was intended for number 19, Cerati. Dan Hennessy. It's the first time we've seen him out on this ice today.
You can certainly see there's a lot of hustle in the Sheehan guys tonight. Kick, a very dangerous play.
Oh.
Thankfully, Carly was able to handle that. Pat flicked back to the goalie, almost turned into a disaster for the Sheehan side.
An attempt by Colin Bowden from the blue line. A little bit of a rush down the rink.
Sheehan's defense looks very ready to accept what they're given here, and then they're able to clear it out rather easily. The question is, though, is the Sheehan offense a little bit slow on the first period? As you said, that it was similar last game, right?
Yeah, it seemed as though last game, even though we did pull through 8-2, the defense was equally matched up. Oh, looks like there's a shot just behind the net.
Shane Duhamel with a big hit on Sal.
He's one of their top players for Lyman Hall.
And Jimmy's there to kind of catch it, make sure it doesn't get out of hand.
Yes. Plays deep up top and tries to feed the puck.
Ooh, and Jimmy
hits
a big hit.
Tough
hit
by Jimmy McAmey. I can't imagine absorbing a hit on ice is very comfortable.
And the Sheehan pit is putting in their 2 cents.
Looks like Kyle Losey is down there with the megaphone. There's a big crowd out tonight from both sides. The tip hit, loud as ever.
And Dan Hennessy is tracking that right. He's
shot on goal, just shy.
And they're able to clear the zone. That's a tumble
by Jack Andino.
I'm a little surprised that there's not a... Oh, there is an arm in the air. Okay. I was a little surprised. The far side referee caught that. I'll give the Sheehan side a little bit of a chance to reset themselves and go on the attack. This is their first power play of the night.
The penalty for Lyman Hall side was on number 4.
Lyman Hall doesn't fill out their roster sheets completely.
We have some miscellaneous numbers.
Yeah, they'll work on that for next year. Shot on goal.
By number 25, Paul Gazzo.
And Mike Capozzi, as captain, do a nice job. Lead the guys out there, set them up. And
so
I like the patience of Sheehan right here. No one's rushing.
No. Nice and gentle, and it was just intercepted by number 15, CJ Tangredi, taken out by number 25, Paul Gazzo. And we have just recovered the puck back.
And Gazzo's storming down. All right, now they're getting reset.
Let's see if they can
There's
set up
a stick
play.
Loose. Lyman Hall player without a stick.
They'll continue to play for it.
Yeah. Now he's just a checking machine. And there's our
And there's a goal by number.
Look at number 15, I think. But we gotta see the shirt.
Let's see. Is it 19 Mike Cerati?
May have been. We'll get the confirmation from the booth. That was a great. The goal went in. Everyone kept playing. No one knew it went in but him. He saw it go right in the back of the goal. And luckily, he put his arms in the air, and the referees confirmed it. And that's a good, aggressive start for Sheehan.
And another face-off.
Lyman Hall wins this one.
And
that is a fantastic move by Sal there. Holy moly.
And the goal was just confirmed for number 19, Michael Cerati, putting him up to 16 goals on the season.
Sheehan's look like they're awake and they are on the attack. I think Lyman Hall is in real trouble now.
I told you, once they get their wheels turning, they're rearing to go.
And that's a great steal from number 7.
Colin Bodwin headed down the ice. 2-on-2 and down.
Lyman Hall kept it in the zone for Sheehan, which is a little surprising. And here's 1 versus 4.
Dan Hennessy on defense, blocked by Carly.
That almost looked a bit of a desperation shot by Tangredi right there. Just kind of pitched it in, hoping.
19, Cerati headed down.
Ooh.
And he was abruptly shut down.
Oh, he just missed it. That was
just
1 inch wide. That was really a great play.
Another shot.
And they're not. And Lyman Hall's. Oh,
and
it's
in. In. Number 8, Christian Giacondino.
Sheehan is making this look easy.
Once they get a drive going, nothing's stopping them.
You know, that Lyman Hall goalie would have been much better served falling on the puck, controlling it. That bounced off him about 3 or 4 times. Turned out to be a big loss for them. Unbelievable. 6 minutes and 36 seconds left in the first period. Sheehan is up 2-0 and completely dominating this first period.
We're back to the drawing boards with another face-off.
Lyman Hall is chanting USA. I guess.
Their sea of orange.
Yeah.
Some rough hits here tonight.
And Carly's having no problem picking that puck up off the ice.
It doesn't seem as there's like that much power behind this puck tonight. They're not, as you said before, kind of tapping and hoping for
it's
the
like
best.
It's like they want to get the stat for shot on goal without actually
putting
know,
in the effort or something. Yeah.
And Sheehan wants to change their line, so they pitch it down, give their guys a break.
Bodwin
which is a smart
back
move.
On the ice. Both Bodwins on the ice.
Paul Gazzo sends it up.
Oh.
And Lyman Hall caught that. That was
great
a good
shot
save.
On goal.
Very nice save.
By Colin Bodwin.
So Sheehan gets a little break, gives their second line a chance to go fight it out for a little bit. Sheehan wins the faceoff, keeps it in the offensive zone. And Lyman Hall is able to pitch it out.
Jimmy McNamee sends a shot deep. Recovered by Lyman Hall.
There's a lot of hits taking place.
Nice slam by Sal Gazzo.
A great slap shot.
Hennessy recovers.
And there is a whistle on Lyman Hall. I don't know what that hand signal is. Do you know what that hand signal is?
No, all I know is when that hand
the
is raised.
The penalty is fist
that
in hand, whatever that means.
It looks like Boomer De Palma.
Tomorrow. Boomer Tomorrow, sitting down for a little bit.
He's got a nice 2 minute with 4:54 left.
He's got some cheerleaders in the box with him. I don't know. They're dancing. They're having a good time in there. All right.
Over in the box over there?
I don't think he's too worried about being in that box.
That when
great
you have
shot.
Managers
oh, my goodness.
Here.
Dan Hennessy sends it in. Put away by number 19, it looks like. Mike Cerati.
Mike Cerati with another goal. 17 goals.
I think he just wants to put up his stats. He's, you know, he wants to get on that sheet. It was
he
a nice, firm slap shot from Dan Hennessy. It allowed him to finish it off.
Great job, boys.
4 minutes and 48 seconds to go in the first period. And it's now 3-0. Sheehan. Well, if Lyman Hall's going to have any hope, I think they got to do something about Mike. I mean,
they have to stop him. Him and Christian, once they get going, they're not stopping. Just the same with Colin on his defense. Jamie Nodafrancesco, a freshman, checked in, number 3. A great addition to the team this season.
Cerati's got the puck again. I don't think Lyman Hall's learned their lesson. Oh, now they're starting to figure out this is the guy to cover. And the puck is loose. Lyman Hall goalie can't handle that.
Looks like we have a few other fresh sets of legs out
yeah,
here.
Nick,
we have
Nick Candido's working the puck.
And 22 Ben Nazer looking to work around there, looking for an open pass in front of goal.
Every Sheehan play. Oh.
A little far, send him.
It gets by Paul, but it looks like just the opportunity Sheehan and Lyman Hall needed to get their lines changed over. There's a shot, and Carly has a great save.
Looks like Jimmy went a little far out on that. Slammed over there. Wow, these hits are relentless.
Well, you can see a little frustration, Lyman Hall. I think they might want to hit a little more and instead of shooting, which they should probably go the other way. There is a penalty. It looks like it's going to be against the Sheehan side. They're sending number 17, Jimmy McNamee, to the box. He has his own little fan club in there cheering him up.
Managers consisting of Krista Nodafrancesco and Nicole Kiernan.
Seriously, this penalty box, he looks like he's having a good time in there. I don't know.
It's a party in the
box.
It's
a party in the box.
See, this rink is different because at Choate, the penalty boxes are completely separate from where the managers work.
Ah.
But here it's combined and the scorekeepers just fit into the middle. It looks
and
a little
it's a breakaway
smush.
By number 7. Oh, right Ooh. Off. That was Colin Bodwin. Great shot by Colin. There's a minute 30 left in the power play. And Sheehan is not only killing the penalty, but they got some aggression going on. They're sending someone up into the offensive zone just to make it a little bit more difficult. And a fantastic clearance.
By Paul Gazzo.
Fantastic clearance. Went right through everybody. Now we're down to almost a minute in the power play. They've killed half of it.
Oh, Lyman, what is happening over here? Looks like they're getting their stick stuck. Sheehan boys couldn't get themselves out.
I've never seen that happen before.
Me neither.
Mechanical difficulties. Ooh.
Puck stolen by number 25, Paul Gazzo.
Mike Capozzi's out there. He's not allowing them to get anywhere near the goal.
No.
40 seconds left in the power play. Sheehan's looking to clear it for the kill. And Sal Gazzo clears it right down. That's great. Line change for Sheehan. Get some fresh legs in there.
Looks like we have Hennessy, Cerati.
20 seconds left, and you can see Lyman Hall is looking for one more charge on this. And Sheehan's able to break it up.
By Cerati again.
Sheehan with possession. 10 seconds left. Puck flying down the ice. Goalie stops it, so there's no icing. And here comes Lyman Hall. Full strength now for Sheehan. Everybody's back into it. And Jimmy McNamee looks hungry.
Just hopefully not for more penalties, but for good defense.
Mike Capozzi brings it in.
Go, Christian.
Great shot.
Just shy of that.
That was tough. Jimmy really kept that in the blue line just by the force of will. Shot on goal. It's loose.
Capozzi trying to do something with it.
45 seconds left in the period. And the zone is cleared. Lyman Hall has no forward momentum. Sheehan defense is really slowing him down. Here they go.
A pass intended for Manny right Castro is intercepted by number
Christian's
8.
Christian's all alone out in front and shoots it.
Oh,
it was a good save by the Lyman Hall goalie. 25 seconds left in the period. Sheehan's trying to attack one more on to really demoralize it.
You got a forward pass to Sal Gazzo. Looks like it's him. Oh, just
over
shy.
The goal. Oh, that was a big hit. That was a big hit. There is a penalty coming. There is a penalty coming. He got a hit right to the head. Sal Gazzo gets right back up, but man, that's a big hit. And when you go to the head, that's an illegal hit.
Number 6, Shane Duhamel. Looked like there was a little discrepancy with him and Colin Bode with number 7.
And he goes to the party box. Three seconds left in the period. If Sheehan could get something out of this, that would be something. But the reality is that's going to be really the advantage is going to happen next period. Puck's loose. Shot just misses goal.
And that will conclude our first period. Titans lead 3-0.
Now, at the end of the period, what's your impression of the Sheehan offense?
I believe that at the start of this, the Sheehan offense was a little shaky. I mean, they first came out and it was like fairly matched, but I feel like once that they realized who's on who and position-wise, they're starting to pick out bonuses and they're trying to figure it out. And looks like towards the end, we started to pick it up a little bit and been putting them in.
And I gotta give a lot of credit to the Sheehan defense. I think more than anything, the Sheehan defense kept that puck in the offensive zone. They've had many opportunities because of what the defense have done. There were a few shots to Sheehan goal. Carly handled them easily. But really, the tale of the tape is that you can see Jimmy McNamee and Dan Hennessy coming out there. They're keeping the puck up forward and giving the offense those opportunities.
And huge credit as well to number 24 captain Mike Capozzi. He's in the midst of everything there. And also to number 19 Mike Cerati. It seemed as though every play, looking putting on the points on the board, he was involved in somehow defensively or offensively.
So we're going to take a break for the Zamboni. We'll be back for the second period. This is your Sheehan High School Journalism and Media Program, and we love Sheehan Athletics. And we're back right before the second period. I'm here with Shane Kremzar.
How's it going?
He's a former Sheehan hockey star and back to visit. Shane, what do you think about what you saw here in the first half?
I love it. It's great play right now. Sheehan, taking over, basically.
So what's Sheehan got that Lyman Hall is lacking today?
I think they got a lot of speed. They came out to play. You can definitely tell. I think they're just, falling behind a little bit over there.
Now, offensively, Sheehan is really on point.
Yes.
How about the defense of Sheehan? What's really happening that's special there? Because it seems like Lyman Hall can't penetrate the offensive zone.
They're holding them great at the blue line, and there's a lot of blocked shots. That's what wins games, really. So blocking shots, it's huge.
Thanks a lot. And this is, again, former Sheehan hockey star Shane Kremzar coming back to visit. Thank you very much, Shane. We appreciate that. All right, and we have the second period about to start. That was a great interview with Shane. It was nice to see him, some of the Sheehan faithful coming back.
And that'll be on YouTube, Shane.
Oh, I will tell him later. We'll give him the link, right? We'll give him the link.
Oh, yes.
We'll tweet that link. That's how hip I am.
I can tweet it at him.
That's right. That's right. Okay, now we're back. We got everything back together. Thank you to our producer and cameraman, Steve O'Donnell, working the camera, and our production assistant, Augie Lacauzzi, tonight. And I'm here with Bree Precicelli as we get ready to watch this great period. What do you think, Bree?
I think that they're going to come out fired up and ready to go, just where they left off at the end of the first period.
That's right. All right. Now, we got some movement. I think that they're just kind of feeling things out. Do you think that coming into a period, it takes a little while to get things loose, or what?
I mean, I feel like the first period is where they kind of, like, warm up and kind of not break out of their shell, but they really loosen up and get a feel for their opponent and, like, working together unity-wise. But I feel like right now they're just going to keep propelling. I mean, it'll take a minute. They just came off a little bit of a break.
And so Sheehan right now is, a little error in the music there. I don't, sound like somebody got electrocuted up in the booth. Oh, that's dangerous. That's dangerous.
BJ, fix it.
All right, Sheehan's got their stuff together, moving down the ice. You got Capozzi with the puck. He looks very comfortable up there.
What were Shane's thoughts on the game?
He was really impressed with the defense, but I think the offense, the passion and the speed of the offense is something that is remarkable.
That's what impressed him the most after watching the first period?
I think so. I'm paraphrasing, so it might not be totally accurate. But
some hockey lingo mixed into there from
yeah.
him.
Ooh, that's
recovered
dangerous.
By Bodwin.
Dylan's protecting that puck, keeping it in the zone. Things are slowed down, but Sheehan is now set up again. Dan Hennessy, takes a hit to the face by number 12.
Boomer.
The ref was looking the other way when that happened.
Ironic how that happens.
Comes out of the zone. Yes, every time the ref looks away, there's a hit to the face.
Hennessy just crossing over the blue line.
And he's doing a nice job mixing it up, bringing it in. Oh, he wants a goal.
And
he puts it in the goal. A backhand goal. Holy mackerel.
Wow. Nice change of speed there. Put it right into the back of that net.
They had 3 seconds left in the power play. And you know what? Dan said, I'm tired of playing all this defense. I want to get an offensive goal. He took it up there, backhanded thing right in the back corner. That
Who
could
would blame
not have been
him?
Better if you drew it up on film. Excellent work. Looks like the Sea of Orange is taking a nap now. It's 4-0. Sheehan, 13:06 left in the second period.
And false start on that faceoff. Lyman Hall was missing one of their players. And a substitution.
And I think the Titan Pit tonight has the giant player heads.
Yes, the player head cutouts of their seniors.
Now, if that doesn't inspire you as a senior, I don't know what will do it. Oh, Sheehan.
The Titan pick just keeps keeping on, impressing and impressing and impressing some more. First the megaphone, the head cutouts, the painted bodies winning CT Best football
There's painted
fans.
Bodies?
There were painted bodies a few games ago. I'd like to mix it up a little bit and keep sparking new ideas.
Ben Nays are doing a nice job keeping it down in the offensive area.
That's impressive.
Everyone's touch. Oh, Jimmy McNamee back out there. Watch out for this guy.
A little bit of a line change. Nona Francesco back in the game. He's one to keep an eye on.
Oh, and the puck is loose right in front of the goal. Cerati almost got another one.
Looks like it was a deflection off the knee pad.
It's unbelievable, this guy.
Solid hit over in the corner.
And the puck clears the zone. Carly comes out, clears it out of that goal area. Lyman Hall goes for a line change. Lyman Hall wants a goal, but they're struggling to get their guys on the ice, period.
Well, I mean, if you look at take a look at the benches, you see many more packed heads and shining helmets over there on our side.
And Sheehan gets an opportunity for a break here if they can get past these players. 2-on-2.
Oh, it looks like Christian set up Cerati. Paul Gazzo.
I like the fact that they're still hustling. I mean,
nice
Paul hustled down there, hit him, and he's still fighting for the puck. The puck is still not in Lyman Hall's possession, and Sheehan comes up with that.
Nice little wraparound pass there. Looks like it was going to be a slap shot from the blue line.
And Sheehan clears it.
Christian Giacondino on the run with a pass to Sal. Setting each other
That's
back up, it
move.
Looks like.
Broken up by number 7 in Lyman Hall. We don't
Some
know,
zigzag
what, we don't know who that is because that wasn't on the roster. I like Dan Hennessy moving this real close to the goal. I mean, this kid's no joke.
Capozzi taking a little bit of a break. Looked like he subbed in for Dylan Bodwin.
And Dylan likes mixing it up, it seems. He's throwing a lot of hits. I think he's having a good time with that.
Dylan's a very visual player. He could kind of scope out the plays and move and adjust himself.
Oh, I thought I was going to be in. Bounced up over the
net. That was a great setup.
Into the back of the goal. And she is just, it looks like they're doing shooting practice. Oh.
Oh. Great try by number 15.
Sal grabbed it. I mean,
Sal Gazzo.
And Dan takes another shot. This is unbelievable.
Shots
it's like a machine
shots.
Gun at the goalie here.
Relentless.
This never stops. The pace has definitely slowed down this game, and Sheehan's just taking shot after shot. And Jimmy McNamee gets it back in there. He wants his teammates to keep shooting.
Oh, it looks like 15 and 10
and Dan
for
keeps
Bowler.
It in the zone.
Nice, Dan Hennessy.
Keep that kid out there. With Dan and Jimmy out there, they can shoot all day. And Dan takes one for himself.
That was through the skates of about four players.
And Jimmy takes a break.
25, Paul Gazzo in for him. Dylan looks like he missed the puck there.
And Carly is ready for it, but it's not on goal. Lyman Hall sends in some fresh legs. We're going to need, there's a good hit by number 14 on Lyman Hall, Manny Castro. All right, now Sheehan starts to move. There's definitely a slowing of this game, which is worrisome for Sheehan. We got to get the pace picked up again.
Once they have the lead, they got to keep that momentum up. I mean, right now we're 4-0. Leading with 8:26 left into the second period.
Someone sat on Mike's knees there, and that didn't look good. Didn't look comfortable. Mike Capozzi. Oh,
the ref. Looks like he just. fell into the board.
I hope he's okay. Oh, and the puck is loose again. This is unbelievable. There has been no break for about 3 or 4 minutes now.
Finally, looks like they're needing a little bit of a break.
They take an icing break. Carly wasn't waving it there. Everyone's going to get a chance to get some fresh legs on the ice. We got Dan and Jimmy back in there. And Mike Cerati's taking a break, which I bet you Lyman Hall right now is saying thank God.
Job well done by him in these first two. I'm sure there's going to be much more of us to see of him.
And Lyman Hall has, what, too many people on the ice? I mean, that's unbelievable. I mean,
Jimmy missed that one, sent far deep.
And they take the icing. That's it'll give him a chance to reset. Looks like Lyman Hall's new strategy is just kind of like chop it down there and see if they can get there in time, but Sheehan's people are always there.
Lyman
Hall's an genuine 2-on-1 opportunity. Oh,
and
they missed.
That would have been something great to take advantage of.
Hey, when you're down, you have an opportunity like that. You got to do it. You got to hit it.
You got to put it in.
And they cleared the zone.
Four racing up there.
Christian's keeping an eye on that puck. He doesn't want to get too far out of there.
20 with the kick. Candido.
Looks like everyone's getting a chance to touch that
Hennessy
puck tonight.
Again. Missed again.
Jimmy's playing very aggressively. Oh, and the puck is in front of the net, but Carly ensures that that's not a possibility.
Great work by her this game.
Tell you, Boomer and Jimmy are mixing it up right in front of that net right there. I wouldn't want to be between those two guys. And the zone is cleared.
Done on the run, Candido rushing up.
And very wisely, Dylan hung back so he didn't get the offside call.
Ooh. The puck is still loose.
And it's a shot on goal. It is a save by the goalie. That was a quality shot, quality save, both sides. And there is an icing call. And these tunes are really getting me pumped up. If
that's
Mr. Cirillo's back
thinking.
There mixing, DJ VJ is doing a great job.
DJ VJ.
Yeah, absolutely.
He's been spinning them back there. I want to start singing. I don't know if that's prohibited, though.
Oh.
We might lose some ratings.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll edit. We'll check it in editing and see if it's any good. And number 15, Sal Gazzo with the puck, setting up the offense. Been a relatively quiet second period. Started with the power play. It hasn't been any since. Oh, and that looks...
Shot on goal.
Oh, it's still loose.
The goal is still loose. Down. Recovered by Lyman Hall.
And in the zone.
Slap shot by Gazzo,
oh,
and it went
just
in.
Missed. Bounced off the very bottom of the goalie's foot. I thought that was a death.
I thought it was in.
Backhanded.
Ooh.
And there's a scrum. Four Lyman Hall players can't clear it out of the zone. Big hit in the corner.
Bodwin, one of their top defensive players. Well,
Collins not worried about it. Number 18, holy. Dylan
Bodwin.
They got the
Bowden
two brothers.
Brothers.
Don't mess with the brothers when you're back in the corner because they both knocked the other guy down.
Oh,
and there is a penalty.
Brothers on this team. We got the two Gazzo brothers. We got the Bodwins. And then we have the brother and sister duo of the McNamees.
And Dylan gets put in the box. He did kind of mug the guy, but, you know, he was messing with his brother. It was an emotional moment.
Emotional moment.
Yeah.
And we got 2 minutes on the board for Dylan, 5:13 to play here in the second period, and Sheehan is still up for 2-0.
Lyman Hall takes a shot, and let's see if they can get any momentum
going.
Paul
Gazzo, bringing it up. Looks like we got a 2-on-1. It looks like it was a pass to Mike.
Ooh. All right, Lyman Hall is coming back. Now, Sheehan's still shooting on power plays here. Let's see if they can make the kill. Mike Capozzi wisely stays with the player because he dumps it to no one.
Great play by him.
And look at this. Breakaway. Capozzi, one-on-one. Oh, that would have been a great move.
Would have been a great setup for him.
Capozzi's not giving up, though. He wants to play penalty kill by keeping it in the other goal, I think. That's the gist. You know, Sheehan's playing smart. You notice they always have a guy in the back protecting, making sure there's no kind of issue. And they're sending people up to be aggressive. It could be why they're up 4-0 right now.
It looks like that's the way it's got to be. I mean, we saw before Hennessy and Jimmy McNamee stopping everything at the blue line and kept setting their offensive players up for shots. That's definitely a strength of these boys tonight.
And Lyman Hall scores.
By number 3 on Lyman Hall. The first goal we've seen from Lyman Hall was 4 minutes and 1 second.
Well, you know, he shot that goal from a little bit of distance, and I think that may have been just hard for Carly to pick up. But, you know, in her defense, there was our defense was spread wide. We didn't expect him to do that. Well, Lyman Hall makes the game. They get a score. 4-1 right now. Sheehan, 4 minutes left, and they're back to full strength. Lyman Hall again wins the faceoff. Lyman Hall is doing a much better job with picking up the faceoffs.
Another shot knocked off by Carly.
Great save by Carly.
Sal Gazzo's on the run here.
Jimmy keeps it in the zone.
Puck sent to the stands. Coach is ducking over there.
Yeah, I think it might have bounced off the referee's forehead.
The referees are taking a beating
tonight. They're taking
tonight.
A beating tonight. I would not want to be them.
They're a part of the rivalry, it seems.
Maybe they get a hazard pay. I don't know.
I don't know what would possess me to be a hockey goalie. I mean, not a goalie.
And the LH fans have come to life. They were snoozy a little few moments ago, but now they're back alive.
It was a revival.
Got the big man from Lyman Hall charging down, Nick Picaro.
Lost the puck.
and they love this country.
USA chant.
Carly with a great save. A high puck, lots of spin. Very hard to control. Great save. And the Sheehan defense here cleared out.
Nice.
By number three.
Jimmy McNamee.
No, Jimmy and other Francescos cleared that one. That was a great clearance. Now they got to get to reset their lines. All right, looks like Sheehan's going to get the faceoff on their side. And the puck comes loose. Lyman Hall takes a shot on goal. Great save by Carly.
Save.
She was screened.
There
you
on
couldn't
defense.
See a thing. Oh, and she saves another one.
And it slips past her. The score is now 2, Lyman Hall.
Lyman Hall cuts the deficit to 2. I think what we're looking at here is we're seeing a definite slowdown on the Sheehan side. Everything's getting slower. As the game has slowed down, Lyman Hall has been able to get momentum back. They have got to get back in this game with a little energy.
They have to hold their own game and not the other team determine their attitudes towards the game and momentum.
And they got Sarati in there. Now he's moving. I think he's pissed.
Deflection off of a Lyman Hall.
Christian's getting that puck down there. All right, Jimmy McNamee trying to control the ball, the puck down the. Oh,
lost
it's a miss,
and it's
missed
up.
Opportunity for Lyman Hall. And there's. Luckily, Carly was a fantastic
wow.
save off the chest protector. That couldn't have felt good. But Cerati's got the puck, and it's 2-on-1.
Oh,
it's,
a, and just
it's
shy.
Unbelievable.
That pass.
Minute 30 left in the period. Sheehan wants to drop another one in goal before this period's over. Shot by 24.
Michael Capozzi.
Sheehan setting up. They want to make wide shots, and they don't make it wise on there.
Nota Francesco off.
There is a penalty coming. Oh, and there should be 2. Maybe not. Well, if you know, you always want to see an exciting game, and Sheehan has basically all of a sudden taken a nap halfway through the second period. And Lyman Hall is really showing them the tough stuff. They believe now.
Nota Francesco in the box for 2 with 1:08 left to play. I wonder what it's like in there.
Looks like a cross-check penalty, but I could be wrong on that.
We got siblings in there. Chris and Nota Francesco manager and freshman brother in there right now.
And the LH fans are chanting away. The first time they've had a real moment of excitement. Less than a minute left in the period. And there's a Sheehan clear. Fans are happy about that. Dylan Bowden's down there. He's,
taking a little bit of a fall there.
Yeah.
It was him versus 3 Lyman Hall players there. 34 seconds left.
Oh, my goodness.
Goal in.
The long shot bounces off Charlie's glove and goes in the goal. This second period has been Lyman Hall's period. And there are still 33 seconds left. If Sheehan doesn't do something, trouble time.
Stop him now. The sea of orange.
You know, senior night, they're inspired, as we talked before, some stuff off the ice that's getting them fired up. This is just what they were looking for. Now we have a game in our hands, and Sheehan better dial in and focus to finish off this period, at least not let another goal or another penalty, because that sloppy play is leading to these kind of things happening.
They're hurting themselves right now. 12 on goal.
Very fortunate, man.
Nice save on goal by Carly.
I mean, you'll notice the shots on goal are completely in Lyman Hall's favor now. I mean, Carly's getting peppered over here. That was not happening in the first period.
The defense has been shifted.
Well, Sheehan's resting on their heels. Instead of going forward, they're sitting backwards, just kind of letting the clock tick out. Now there's a one-goal deficit. Oh, that looked like something. The referees don't call that.
A little bit of beef out there.
A little stabbing. Is stabbing a penalty? It should be, because that's just what happened. Well, at the end of the second period, it is Sheehan's only winning by one goal. But Lyman Hall has come out with an amazing second period. Fired up. They looked unstoppable in that period. And Sheehan's got to turn it around. What can they do to turn this thing around that last period and really hold on for the win?
They have to keep their own momentum. As you can see right now, I mean, the momentum has shifted to us in the first period with Majorin, like, holding most of it. And now we go to the second period, and now we look at the score. Scoring three in maybe about 3 or 4 minutes, if that, towards the end. So we need to have a momentum shift and have some confidence. I mean, I feel Coach Festa, head coach of Sheehan Titans, is going to go in there and try to pump them back up and tell them what they got to do to get the job done in order to pull out successful tonight.
Well, this completely biased Sheehan broadcast will be back after the Zamboni clears the ice really soon, where we hope we have a fantastic finish. This is a very exciting game here at the Northford Ice Arena, and we'll be back after this. And we're back at the beginning of the third period. We got Sheehan and Lyman Hall coming in and warming up, preparing for the third period of action. We saw the first period, a dominant Sheehan Titan team out there, scoring at will. Mike Cerati just couldn't be stopped. Second period, there was a bit of a pace change, and we saw all of a sudden Sheehan was on their heels. And the shots on goal were many, and it was very difficult for them to stop. So right now is Sheehan 4, Lyman Hall 3. Is Lyman Hall's, I believe it's their senior night, and they found the inspiration. You hear in the background, "Don't Stop Believing" playing by Journey. Well, Lyman Hall is certainly believing it right now. And the real question is, can Sheehan turn around this third quarter? And we certainly hope they can.
As the clock starts to count down in this last third period, wrapping it up, Sheehan has got to turn it on.
To Lyman Hall coming down. Oh, a shot on goal very early by Lyman Hall. Now Sheehan's got to clear that zone. They got to set the tempo here. It's like they're about to. Number 19, Mike Cerati. He's out for blood and shot on goal. And Dan Hennessy keeping in the zone. He's doing a fantastic job at that tonight. I really have to say I'm very impressed with him. He kind of has like an eagle eye for that.
Cerati on another awesome play.
And there's some checking in the corner. It's a bit of a scrum.
Capozzi handled himself.
And Dan Hennessy out there fighting for the puck, looking for his teammate. That's a very
great
smart
pass.
It's in the Sheehan zone with Sal Gazzo chasing it. But it's going the other way. Looks like the Sheehan's playing much more of a team game this third period. A lot more passing, a lot more team unity. Around the back, number 18, Dylan Bowden.
Pass to his brother there, number 7, Colin.
Ooh.
Tough check.
Yeah.
Who's in that?
The shot on goal and score by Dylan.
With assist by number 15, Sal Gazzo.
You know, that looked easy for him. That looked easy.
And that makes you wonder why we didn't turn that on in the second period.
Yeah, where was that last period? Brought the ball up, kept it aggressive. You had your defenseman keeping the ball in play, or the puck in play. And he hit that puck right through the, it didn't even have to lift it. Beautiful shot. And there's a little bit of a discussion over there.
Difficulties over there on the side.
Yeah, something's going on.
15 and 11 on the faceoff. And Sheehan recovers.
Sheehan into the zone. Oh, that's a nice hit by Sal over there in the corner. Oh, he just punched him in the head, number 11. Nick Beccaro just punched him in the head. But I guess in hockey that's legal. Lyman Hall drops in the zone. Cleared out very easily.
Recovered by Dylan. Back to his brother up. Now. Get a reversal of roles here. Nice little push.
And that's cleared, I believe, because he was pursuing.
See Dylan.
And Lyman Hall is able to bring it into the zone, but they met with some resistance. Paul Gazzo not allowing him to come in easy.
Let's go.
And
Paul
is able
up.
To clear it out. Sheehan gets a line change. Captain's coming in, Capozzi and Giacondino. Mike Sarai, oh, handling the puck masterfully.
Wow. That little spin around there.
Oh, and then he gets hit. But can they keep it in play? That's what matters. Jimmy McNamee keeping that puck in. Very quick to it. Oh. And they have to clear the zone, unfortunately.
Jimmy's got to keep on D here.
And Carly with a great save. Very great. It's a bouncing puck, no problem for her. Another shot.
Another save. And
Jimmy goes, oh, Jimmy with a good hit.
A little bit of a fight there, though, but they're stuck.
I want to see Jimmy hit some more. That was great. Mike Capozzi bringing it up and a shot.
Oh.
Just over. But Sheehan's being relentless. This is the Sheehan we saw in the first period. This is much better.
This is, I think, yet the best period that they've played. I mean, not scoring-wise, but... They've matched up pretty well in defense. Got a little bit aggressive.
Oh, there's a shot on goal. Bounced right off the goalie. Had to sting a little.
Can't imagine what that must feel like.
We'll have to ask Carly sometime. Puck is kept in the offensive area. Shot on goal.
Shot on goal. And it's a goal.
That was number 18. That was Dylan Bowen.
Dylan Bowen. That gets us.
Okay.
Sheehan 5, Lyman Hall 3 with 10:46.
Sheehan 6.
Now 6.
Sheehan's now doubled their score. Feel a lot more comfortable now. I think it's just they like this net better. They like shooting that direction. That's got to be it.
It's got to be something about that side, huh? Which is ironic because Lyman Hall's over there.
I think they just want to show Lyman Hall other goals. That's got to be it. Hennessy had a little fan club there. I think a bunch of cheers going for him. Puck is brought up.
He's been a really reliable player this season.
And the
shot by 7, Colin.
The puck is, they are attacking that Lyman Hall goal.
Oh, and it's shot back out. No, Francesco.
Oh, he's crushed, but the puck is in play. You can hit him all you want, but the puck is in play. I don't think he's paid attention to that puck.
Barely knocked him down. He got himself right back up.
And there's a penalty on Lyman Hall. So Sheehan gets to keep playing it until the Lyman Hall possesses, which they just do. Penalty. They're going to call it into the box. 9:49 left in the game. 2-minute penalty on number 11. That is on Nick Beccaro. See a little frustration on the Lyman Hall side, and with good reason. They had a great second period. It came out flat in the third. And Christian's moving that puck back and forth, up and down on that side. He's commanding it at will. You know, Mike behind the net. He's so dangerous it makes everybody else watch. Oh, and a bad pass.
A nice little swing around there. Yeah. In the hands of Michael Cerati and off to Michael Capozzi.
Yeah, Jim had a little bit of a bad pass. He was able to recover, though. So Paul Gazza is going to bring this thing up to the captain.
Michael Capozzi.
Sheehan's looking calm, but they don't want to lose that passion. Shot on goal deflected by Lyman Hall. And Lyman Hall chucks it, just dumps it down to the zone. Carly handles that with ease. Oh, Lyman Hall's tired, wanted a line change. Sheehan gets some fresh legs himself.
You know, it's got to be tricky. I mean, we have two lines still that haven't even gone out. And Lyman Hall subbing in their same old players back in and out.
Well, the depth of the Sheehan lines, we can see that pretty soon. If this thing stays where it is, I mean, we're still on the power play right here. And Lyman Hall is shooting, which I can't fathom how that's happening. And I worry about Sheehan keeping that intensity.
Boomer is getting a little aggressive down there on the Lyman Hall side.
It was a good save by the Lyman Hall goalie.
And a great attempt by Sal Gazzo. Deflection on Collins' shot.
2 seconds in the power play. Oh, and it almost was a goal in the last second of it. And it's off into the net. Yet the referees do not blow the whistle, which is, they just missed it. I think the fans helped them with that one a little bit.
I don't think they're going to let much get by.
A lot of C's on the ice for the Sheehan side. They got their scoring line in there. Got Capozzi and Cerati and Christian. A lot of C's.
That's a solid line.
And Dan and Jimmy backing them up. Goes over the goal.
Go,
Cerati backhands it. It's a save by the Lyman Hall keeper.
Wow.
And there is an icing call.
The score is still Sheehan 6 to Lyman Hall 3 with 7:24 left to play here in the third period.
Does look fun to skate out there. I tell you, these guys look like they're just so good at this, they make it look easy.
Yeah, in reality, it's real tiring, let me tell you. It's a killer thigh workout.
And Lyman Hall's in a bit of a breakaway. Nick Beccaro moving the puck down.
Stealing number 17 stick.
If Jimmy picks it right up, he's right back in there.
It's at the end of the pack.
Two on
Looks
two
like
for
he's stubbing out.
There's a shot on goal. The goalie couldn't find it for a second there. It was almost an opportunity.
Fed to three. Oh, just
wide.
Shy.
Jimmy Nota Francesco.
Solid shot there, though, by Nota Francesco.
A very long shot by Lyman Hall's Manny Castro. And they got to come out of the zone to get it in the zone. And it's cleared. Okay. Cerati very wisely got himself out of there. Some smart play by the Sheehan side now. 6 minutes, 20 seconds in the game. Looks like they're doing a waltz.
The waltz.
Yeah.
The waltz in hockey.
The waltz. That's right.
Very interesting comparison here. We got and a little bit of a huddle going on the sideline.
This is rugby. This isn't hockey. That's rugby over there. It's like a scrum.
And who is going to take it out?
The puck clears. Lyman Hall gets it, but a big hit.
Sticks down. Recovered by Paul, and a little swing around here.
And Sheehan's getting a little complacent again. And this is obviously worrisome.
A stop on the skate of number 15, Sal Gazzo.
And there we go. And the puck almost goes in. Dylan almost gets his third goal of the night.
Paul down. That was a missed call by a referee.
Jimmy McNamee sticks it to him.
It's like they both kind of went into the glass there for a minute.
I heard a nice thud when they made contact. That was a good hit. Oh, the DJ is playing the wrong music, I guess. Lyman Hall has a quick one-player rotation.
And two. And three. Sheehan's got to gain control of their momentum again.
And Sheehan's looking a little tired. Looks like they could use a little bit of a break. But there's 4:45 left of the game, and they're still surging. Oh, Dylan held on. I cannot believe it. And shoots on goal. And it's no goal. Held on. But that was very close.
Wow, that was a close one, folks.
Looked like there was some butter on that puck. I thought the goalie was going to blop it right in for him. Well, Sheehan's going to get a bit of a change here.
Let's see who we got out there. Surratt, Christian, Dan Hennessy,
still
Capozzi.
Have the shooting line out. Now, 4.5 left. We might see some fresh faces pretty soon with the 3-point difference.
I'm hoping so. I think it'd be good to get them out there and a little bit of a break.
Yeah.
For these ones that have been going hard all game. Recovered by Cerati.
And but it's broken Knocked up out. By Lyman Hall. Lyman Hall did a nice job to poke that. And the shot on goal saved
and
by Carly.
Saves it.
And they're hitting Carly. It looks like a little interference, but she's able to stay in it.
She's got to get time to recover and reset. There we go. Great work.
Cerati with some fantastic moves. Coming down.
Tried to set up his
gives
boy.
Gives up his teammate, but they couldn't clear
Christian
it out.
Christian knocked down. And Lyman Hall is charging up ahead on this.
And Paul is not going to have that. Paul's not going to let
the
him
nice
come in
slam.
Without a little memoir that he was there.
Capozzi regains.
3 minutes, 30 seconds left in the game. 6-3 Sheehan, 3-point difference. And Sheehan is still fighting.
We got Brian Leach out there. He's a new face, number two.
All right, playing a little defense. So they're going to get the puck down there by the Lyman Hall goal. It's an opportunity.
Sal on the faceoff.
Very aggressive, Sheehan. I like that.
I like it. We have some Titan pits departing.
They're going to go watch the Olympics. That must be it.
The Olympics.
Lyman Hall's got the puck. Breaking away.
Passed off.
Oh, now right off her helmet. Face mask. That if that wasn't the best save of the day.
I've ever seen.
Right
wow.
off of her face.
That was one of the best I've ever seen from Carly. What are the odds, huh?
She wears makeup and can take a puck off the mouth. And it's
and
off
it's
the off
Lyman
Hall
face.
A black eye for a black eye. You gotta make it fair. Another
Carly,
save.
Another save.
She's not letting anything by. Here's Dylan, 3-on-1. Dylan shoots, almost scores again. I mean, at this point, I mean, I know this is slack time, but Sheehan's doing fantastic work.
They picked it back up, and it looks like they're regaining. They just got to keep pushing through for that 2 minutes and 10 seconds left.
And we're seeing if there's any personnel changes. There's some movement on the bench.
Looks like a timeout was called.
Oh, a timeout was called. Getting some pep talks. And what do you say right now if you're the Lyman Hall coach in this situation? You got 2 minutes left, 3 goals. What do you say?
Well, I mean, Lyman Hall was dominating earlier. They went on a 3-point scoring streak. So, I mean, anything's possible, quite frankly. But, I mean, right now it's all about momentum and strategizing on who's going to set up who, who's going to mark up on who, and ultimately who's going to get open to get it in.
I think it's about, too, about just the honor of the game and play strong for these last 2 minutes. Don't turn this into a bloodbath.
What do you think Festa's saying, Coach Head Festa is saying to the Sheehan boys right now?
I think he's saying you guys played very well. And, you know, the two times they've played, Sheehan's been able to dominate the game. That second period is like a bad memory. But let's finish this game strong because, you know what, this is, especially for the seniors, this is the last time they're going to be playing Lyman Hall unless something crazy happens in the postseason. But, you know, let's go out and do this right. And, you know, Carly just took one in the face. Let's keep him out of Carly's face. You know, pretty girl, we don't want her to take it off the face. So finish strong. I think both sides got to think about that. It's all about honor and dignity at this point. They've got their top line in. Sheehan is not done right now.
I mean, it's pretty crazy to think that some of the starters out here tonight, I mean, that are dominating. We have Christian, Michael Capozzi, Jimmy McNamee, all strong seniors, Colin Bodwin, who are for sure going to be missed next year.
Lyman Hall takes the faceoff. The bad pass leaves Sarati wide open and bounces
off the head again.
This is amazing. He really is a great shooter.
That was great placement.
And Sarati really likes hanging out right by that goal. He likes to be there for when that puck
comes. Looking
for that pass. Yeah.
Looking to get fed the puck.
And 1:40 left in the game. Sheehan is not letting up at all.
At this point, I really wish that there were some refreshing faces in there.
Yeah, I was kind of hoping we'd see my favorite player, number four, out there. But
that's who my favorite player is. Yeah. I'd have to agree. Maddie McNamee would have torn some stuff out here tonight.
All right, well, this broadcast we'll look for next year, that's for sure.
We're going to have a feature on her. There we go. 15 just steps back on.
And Sean Gold, yes. Carly, I don't even know where the puck went.
It was stopped.
I think it went.
She caught it, dropped it.
In her knee pad or something. It got lost. Looked like she had to check her wallet and see if the puck was in there.
1:11 left here in the third period. Well, Sheehan leads.
A little excitement
the score
from
remaining.
The DJ.
6-3.
And Sheehan possesses it with a minute left. Oh,
what?
It goes over the net, though.
What was that?
Got flicked out. Jimmy McNamee, a little over-exuberant.
A little flick action over there, huh? Just shy of a minute left.
It's a save
and
again by Carly.
Save by Carly.
I really don't know how many saves Carly had tonight, but it's a ton.
It seems
it's
like every other minute we're saying save by Carly Femniak. Yeah. Save. Props to her.
You know, they scored three on her, but if you looked at percentage, I mean, right now Lyman Hall's pulled their goalie. They got six men out there trying to, you know, bang a puck.
Which
in
I think
there.
Was a smart move.
Yeah, they have no choice at this point.
Let's see here.
And Lyman Hall's in the
it's
offense.
It's like a cluster of maroon over there.
Holding on to a lefty shot.
Stopped by number 25, Paul Gazzo. 18.
And this could be another goal for Sheehan. Oh, off the post. Oh,
man. I'd be kicking myself for that. Great effort.
It was a great shot.
It was a great shot.
Are they calling a penalty or an offside? Let's go. What is this? Offsides. They're going to bring it back. 18 seconds left in the game. Goalie comes back in for Lyman Hall. Now it's time to finish it off.
For a little while here, I was getting nervous that we weren't going to pull through.
Well, you know, that second period's like a bad memory now.
That Trojan stampede came through, and it was getting us a little worried.
Apparently, the Trojans play well in odd-numbered periods, and there's only one of those.
Wow.
Or even, I mean, what the heck.
I got what you meant, and I was quite inspired.
Yeah. And yeah, that's the game.
Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, this is a great – we thank Bree Petroselli for working with us in this broadcast. We thank Steve O'Donnell and Augie Lukowski. Steve, our production manager, and Augie, our production assistant. If you always want to look us up, you can look at our YouTube channel, www.youtube.com/Ivanator732. You can also follow at Sheehan Live, which is the official Twitter feed of the morning announcements. This is Mr. Ives and Bree Petroselli saying –
thank you very much, and congratulations to our own Sheehan Titans on their 6-3 victory over Lyman Hall.
Nice job, Sheehan. Good night.